What up, guys? Alchemist Hunter here, playing some more WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. We're on episode 213, week 74 of Divas. And if you missed Crash Band Pro Wrestling or Pure Intense Wrestling earlier this week, please go back and check it out. If you've missed High Fly Flow, please go back and check that out as well. Shit has been crazy here so far this week, and these weeks are getting better and better as the time goes on. I would say we're 1 second closer, always 1 second closer, always 1 inch closer, always 1 breath away from getting closer to the next game, which is 2K17. I cannot wait to see what goes on in there, not only because of the things I kind of planned, but just, you know, you're moving forward and you want to get to that point, and it just creates for better matches going on into 2K17. So as always, if you're new to this channel and this is new for you and you've never been on this before, I'm Alchemist 100. This is what I do. I play wrestling games. I do not simulate too often, but when I do it the right way. Either way, I play this game fucking hard, and I hope you guys who have been here since the damn near the start of it, or been here or joining me midway, whatever the case may be, you guys know who you are. Thank you guys for tuning in and always fucking having my back. This is not easy to do, and you guys who YouTube know that it's not easy to do at all. That all said and done, though, enough about nice talk. Let's get down to business here tonight here on Divas. Now, Divas will be having their pay-per-view, simply known as Flash Magic, 2 weeks from now, starting the next 2 Sundays from now, which will be the start of the new month. And these girls want to get to that point. These girls want to work their asses off to get to that point to take on champions and win shit. That's what they want to do. So let's see what these girls can do here tonight. Up first, Brittany takes on Christina Monet. And you guys know these two technical geniuses are going to get it going in this one. Christina Monet has the experience edge over Brittany, but Brittany has that fucking ever-loving attitude that she always wants to bring it and always bring her best. Let's see which one of these two can bring their best in this first match here. Our second match of the night, Adrian Cole takes on Alexis Richmond. These two are damn good in that ring, and I mean damn good in that ring. We saw Alexis Richmond being this close, and I mean damn, I can't show you it in this fucking screen, but damn close, damn fucking close to winning that Divas Championship off of Yamashita two pay-per-views ago. So I cannot wait to see what she can do now that she's definitely evolved and learned from past mistakes and past matches. And she takes on Adrian Cole, who's been taken out many before her, has not got a championship shot, but has done a good job of taking out people like Demon Yoshida. I mean, I believe that was a couple weeks ago, and she fucking brought it to her then and got a win over her too, which is amazing, taking on someone like of legend status like Demon Yoshida. So you gotta wonder what the hell these two girls are gonna do when this match happens. We'll find out later on tonight. Our third match, Jessica Paige takes on the returning JP York. We haven't seen JP York in a while. She's looking a little better than she did before. She's always ready to grow up and grow and learn. And even though she may be one of the smallest divas here on Divas, she brings it. She gives it her all. But she's taking on Jessica Paige, who's always somehow finding a way to get a victory. And you don't expect it from a girl like Jessica Paige, who doesn't wrestle too much. She's more of a flaunting and a supermodel-esque style that she brings to that ring. But when she gets in that ring, she gets to work. She's not a former champion for no reason. Anyway, we'll find out who wins this match later on up in our third match. Our fourth match, Naomi makes her return to Divas, and I cannot wait to see this. This is going to be fucking crazy, too. She takes on Yota Hime, and Yota Hime is the one who put her on the shelf in the first place. Naomi is not 100%, I'll tell you that, but she's good enough that she can get herself back in that ring and really bring it to Yota Hime. The question is she ready, or is Yota Hime still above and beyond Naomi? We'll find out later on tonight in our fourth match of the night for the Divas Television Championship, nonetheless. Our fifth match, Angela Lopez takes on Ashley. Ashley always wants to be on top. She always wants to be the fucking dominant female here on Divas, and she wants to show the whole world that she can bring it, but so does Angela Lopez. Angela Lopez has been all over the world, not only here on Divas, but has been all over the world. She's done all that, and now she wants to keep that amazing wrestling style going as she takes on Ashley here. Ashley is not going to be any joke, but neither is Angela Lopez. We'll find out which one of these two can win this thing up next. Sorry, in our fifth match. Our sixth match, Zena Firebird takes on Rachel Raiden. These two are damn good, and they know each other fucking well. Zena Firebird made her return, I believe, last week, I believe, and dominated in her match. She made Star Dulce her bitch at that point. She did what she had to do. And with that all being said and done, Xena Firebird is ready to go in action here. This girl is no joke, but Rachel Radin is no joke either. Rachel Radin has been killing it so far. Let's see if she can keep that streak of hers going. We'll find out later on tonight. In our seventh match, in our main event, Elaine takes on Dami Yoshida. Now, this is where things start getting a little complicated. Now, we've seen Elaine defeat Yamashita. We've seen Dami Yoshida defeat Yamashita as well. And now they're in a 2 out of 3 best 2 out of 3 for the next 3 weeks until the pay-per-view. So that'll be this week, next week, and then the week after that before the pay-per-view. Whoever comes out with 2 victories in this thing will head on to take on Yamashita for that Divas Championship. The question is, who is going to be? We'll find out who can get the first win here tonight, whether it be Elaine or Dami Yoshida. Regardless of such, it'll be a big advantage to one of these two. We'll find out later on tonight in our main event which one of these two can get it going. But up first, Brittany takes on Christina Monet. Let's get it on the road here on Divas. This is our first match of night here, ladies and gentlemen. These two are going to bring it. And if no one else brings it harder than these two, I don't even know. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is no one brings it like these two bring it. And let's see what these two can do in our first opening match here. Locking horns here. Brittany has a little bit of a strength advantage. But then again, Christina Monet has that strength if you can have a strength advantage. Yeah, not to tell the truth, these dudes are pretty even. These two are pretty fucking even here. So see which one of these two can do it here. Locking horns, and now Brittany has the advantage here. Back and forth between these two, no disrespect. I'm hoping there'll be no disrespect at this point. Kick to the midsection. Kick back to her midsection. All right, back in the lockup they are again. And now Christina Monet with the fucking advantage over here, over Brittany now. Two almost mirror images of each other at times. Oof. Whoa, Hurricanrana starting this one off. That's a big move that turned the pace of this thing into Christina Monet's favor. This thing just started here. Taunting her to get up. That's what she has no choice but to do. Brittany's not the person who will stay down to anyone. Showing no fear. It's Brittany. Brittany was damn near close to winning that Crash Japan. Sorry, what am I talking about? Divas Television Championship against Yorihime a couple pay-per-views ago. Nice suplex there with a float over, beautifully done. And Christina Monet was very serious about that pin. She would have threw her legs up on the shoulder. Sorry, yes, on the shoulder of Brittany. That would have made it even more effective. And it had Brittany, you have to use one arm to reverse this, to get out of that pin, forcing her to waste more stamina. And Christina Monet is very smart like that, but not thinking at the moment when you're trying to pin someone half the time. My mic up a little bit. There we go. Oh, Jesus. Kicked her right in the fucking arm. I mean, these girls are ruthless as they come. And they may be nice and cute, but gosh, they will beat the hell out of you. And you see what they're already doing here to each other. You do not want to get in these girls' way by any means. Do not get in their way. Front drop kick right to the fucking chest there. Oh my gosh, fucking A. Monet not playing games here. Probably set up for a Mexican surfboard or a Romero stretch, as some like to call it. Whatever you want to call it, it's a painful submission hold. Trying to hold on as much as you can and letting her go. Kicking right in the fucking chest there. Monet off the ropes. Big time flapjack there. Runs right into fucking doom at this point. Monet's still going. Nice trip up there. Look at Brittany. Holy shit. Brittany with the reversal. Holy shit. Girls are bringing it here. Nice suplex. Beautifully done. Showing off her strength there. Showing off that fucking skill, that athleticism. Almost got tongue-tied saying athleticism there. That was weird. Fucking hey, I'm losing my mind. This is my mind because these girls are fucking doing work right now. And the commentary, it's hard to change the commentary, especially when it's so similar, you know what I mean? These two are so similar as well. Japanese arm drag out of nowhere. That was cool. Kick right to the spine once again. Monet has her exactly where she wants her here. Rubbing her face into the mat. playing a little dirty there, but Crowell still loves her anyway. Monet now. Let's go. Where she wants to go now. A suplex of her own here. Beautifully done. She felt the explosion almost of her body colliding onto that mat there. Going for a moonsault. Oh! Caught nothing but canvas there. And now Brittany ready to take control. Hooks the leg. Nothing but the best to. No! Almost had a delay on that pin. I don't know why I pressed it so late. The fuck's going on with me? Wrenching at that neck there. Very smart is Brittany to wrench at that neck and trying to slow down the pace that Christina May is on right now. Oh! If you're Brittany right now, you gotta watch out for being in this position. Oh! Monet will find a way to hurt you quickly in this one. Would it be the Alabama Slam or something of that sort? And she's setting up for that reverse Alabama. Oh, no, no, Alabama Slam. Oh, my gosh, in the back of her head, bouncing off that fucking bottom rope there. Monet has her where she wants her and bringing her back into the middle of the ring. Very smart, this girl. Very smart, this girl. Setting up. Oh, those legs taking damage. These two are so damn similar, I'm telling you. They just... If the female tag team division was still a thing, trust me, these two girls will probably be on it. Smashing up that elbow. It's one thing I'm hoping they do in 17 is changing the pace of getting in and out of the ring in tag team matches. It's just too, it feels too one-on-one-ish still. You know what I mean? They feel like there's no pizzazz going in a tag team match. That's something I would hope to definitely see. Definitely something you don't want to see is that diving fucking European uppercut hitting it right in the face. Yeah, Monet caught all of that. One, two, no. How the hell did she kick out of that? I have no idea. She went with all fucking full force on that one. That was horrible. Oof. Bring back in control here. Reverse mat slam, throwing her back, the back of her head into the mat. And now Christina Monet may be in trouble here. If Brittany can hit this belly-to-belly suplex, this could be it. Look at that! She got all of it! Oh, shit. Holy shit, this could be it right here. Referee, one, two, no! Monet, very close, very damn close to almost being pinned out here. Brittany, oh! Sets up that double wrist lock, suplex, she got all of it, but didn't hook the leg. Didn't hook the leg, but now trying to hook the leg, and maybe a little bit late. That half a second may cost her. Exactly what I meant. Christina Monet using that fucking Northern Lights suplex, double wrist lock suplex. I couldn't tell exactly what it was, but either way, a finishing move of her own that she loves to use. But it wasn't enough just yet. Oh! That easy could be it right there. Setting up for something, but Brittany, you can see the way she was getting up there. She just knew exactly what she wanted to do. Ooh! Front drop pick again, taking her down. Christina Monet is so damn good and so agile in this ring. She knows how to fucking make moves. Oh! She also knows how to fucking make pain as well. And Christina Monet flying up to the top again here. Cross body right across the chest of Brittany. Wasting no time, hooks the leg once again. And Brittany may be in trouble here too. And she kicks out again at two. And Brittany needs to get herself back into this thing before it's too late. She needs to find a move that's going to really turn this thing around. And a comeback may be something that she needs to do right now. Monet flying off of the ropes. Gets caught with a neck breaker. Floats over nicely. One, two, no. Still staying in this one. And Brittany not done just yet. Waiting for Monet to get up. Let's see what she can do. Close on taking her down. Another one. A third one there. Has her set up in the corner. Christina Monet is putting herself in the corner here. And Brittany now maybe a little walk away with this one here. Let's see what she can do. No! Boo! And again, Brittany just has a little extra speed here. Going for a hurricanrana of her own. I don't know what Brittany has planned, but I think she's just trying to go for a pin at this point. But she has to realize it's not going to be that easy to get a pin over Christina Monet. Monet kicks up before the referee's hand even touches the mat. Damage has been done in this one, but these two are not done just yet. Now sets up. Oh my gosh, look at this. Oh, head scissors DDT. Holy shit, these girls are bringing it here. Renee always trying to perfect that gold round pin. Let's see if she can perfect it here tonight. Let's see what she can do. Let's see what she can do. She got all of it. That has to be it. That has to be it. Two. Oh, and she kicks it at two. It is Brittany. And now Monet taunting her to get up, but I don't think you want her to get up. I think you want her to stay down as much as possible. Whoa, roll up here, roll up here. This could be it. Schoolgirl pin, but no. Another reverse mass slam taking her down. And Brittany back in control. Whoa, Monet so damn quick to roll on the outside there, but getting herself inside a little bit too quick. Wonder what these two girls are going to do here. Roll up here. Small package pin. One, two. No, and she kicks it at two. Does Brittany. Two girls resting at this point. Monet has no choice but to rest at this point. She has nothing else she can do but rest. And now setting for a power bomb. That could be it. Oh, reversal there by Brittany. And now Brittany has back in control here. Sets up another one of those head scissors DDT. She got all of it. How strong this girl is. Set up for a power bomb. Oh! That easy could be it right there. Referee. Two. No. Christine Monet let go. I believe Brittany easily could have been pinned out there. And now trying to get up. But oh, just smack right back down. I think Monet wants to do more damage than what she came in to do. Oh, shit. Out of nowhere. Big time belly-to-belly suplex. She was waiting for her to get up. And that could be it right there. Brittany may have this thing here. Two. No, and she got the three. Brittany out of nowhere with that fucking belly-to-belly suplex, and it took her off her game quick. You saw Monet hesitate for a second there. She gave her a second, and the second's all she needed to fucking turn this match around. Big time moonsault missed right there. This is a little bit in the middle of the match here. Went for a pin, only got nothing off that. These two back and forth, fucking amazing. Here we saw the diving European uppercut. She caught her right under the chin, flush, beautifully done. Didn't get the three just yet. Reverse mat slam, taking her right back down. Sent up for that belly-to-belly suplex. And damn, she got all of it. She got all of it the first time, but it still wasn't enough just yet. Right here, look at this. Smacking her right in the face. It's almost disrespectful. Just trying to tell her to stay down here. You saw, look at the hesitation. The hesitation for a second. And Brittany out of nowhere with that belly-to-belly suplex. And she caught her with all of that. This one is over quickly. And as good as Monet is, that 1 second hesitation cost her so much. Big time win here for Brittany. Holy shit, out of nowhere. This girl is still kicking it. Anyways, up next, Adrian Cole. Takes on Alexis Richmond. Yeah, Alexis Richmond. And speaking of people who fucking have no give, these two girls are amazing in this ring. I'll talk more about them as the next match starts up. Get ready for it. It's up next here on Divas. This is our second match tonight here, ladies and gentlemen. These two want to fucking bring it here already. Show off the strength. But no! Adrian Cole just taunting away at Alexis Richmond, waiting for her to get right back up. And these two in a lockup position here. They see the same thing we saw in the last match. You technically sound wrestlers here, and believe it or not, don't let the look of Alexis Richmond fool you. The girl may be a goofball, but goddamn, when she gets in that ring, she can wrestle. Richmond with the advantage here, headlock. Strength up the goals to Adrian Cole. Richmond though. Very quick, but so is Adrian Cole. Sets up with that back body drop. Don't let Lexi Richmond fool you either. She's very strong for a girl her size as well. Has a little bit less, when it comes to height, has a little bit less than Adrian Cole. But Adrian Cole's no big girl herself. These girls are very tiny in this ring. Oh! Nothing they do in this ring is small by any means. That's what they pull off here. Ooh! Nice fucking strength off that too. Gets down. Oh, super kick just may do it there. Set up for something here. And Lexi Richmond with a reversal. Kicks her right in the fucking back of the shoulder blade there. Knocking her damn near the hell out. Clobbering her right back down. You see her just hit her right in the nose. And Richmond can be very ruthless in this ring. Probably one of the most ruthless women we have in here. And we have some women that are truly just ruthless, and that you can see it in their face. But Richmond can play dirty if she needs to. She will fucking beat the hell out of you and keep on laughing about it too. Sit out slam there, reverse it out slam. Oh! Adrian Cole very flexible to kick that leg back like she did. Reversal out of that somehow, some way to Alexis Richmond. The fucking neck breaker. We just need two technical geniuses. Bring it here. And again. That modified head scissors takedown. Adrian Cole tosses her into the corner. Has no choice but to go into the corner again. Kick right to the right to the fucking bottom of the leg there. Kick right to the legs again. Oh, missed that kick that time. Look at this. Oh my goodness! Holy shit! Alexis can't be 100% at this point, simply because the damage that she took from that match with Yamashita. At the same time, Alexis is still here going. Yamashita is still at times resting. I mean, we love having her as a Divas champion, but how much damage can you take? And all these girls here on Divas are waiting for the opportunity for them to be the next Divas champion. No matter who you are, that's what you're gunning for. Regardless if you're in a tag team or a faction or some kind of group, you always want to be on top. You want to be top dog. If you are here on Divas, whether you're here on Divas, Crash Japan, or Pure Intense Wrestling, you want to be the main champion. Snap mirror off the ropes. Does Lex Richmond go? Drop kick right to the face. Now smashing the back of her head into the mat. Richmond has her in control. And these crew girls keep going and kick right to the leg. Look at this. German suplex. Holy shit, out of nowhere. Adrian Cole has her where she wants her, setting up for something big. Richmond says no. Kick to the back hamstring there. Off the ropes. Sorry, off the rebound there. Oh! Lex is so damn good. And reverses out of that somehow, some way. Richmond has where she wants her now. Tossing her into the corner. This is exactly where she wants to be. Adrian Cole flying at her here full speed, but got caught between those thick legs of Alexis, and she tosses across with that head scissors. Hurricanrana takedown out of the corner. This easy could be it right here, referee. One, two, no. See many people get very close to a three with that before when they take on Alexis Richmond. Richmond now wants to finish with that fucking kick. Maybe going a little too early here. Oh, swatted away. Out of nowhere, that jumping cutter. May do it right there. Referee needs to be on his A game. This could be it right here. Two. No, and Alexis gets out of two. Adrian Cole saw it coming a mile away. Cut her off quickly, wasting no time here. How quickly this girl moves. Oh my gosh, Hurricanrana. Adrian Cole on fire here. Kick to the leg. A kick to the side of the head. Another kick. A back kick to fucking finish things off here. Richmond still fighting back though. Another neck breaker out of the reversal. Slips right through the fucking cracks. And this is what Alexis Richmond does well. And she fucking finds a way to get past you somehow, some way. Whether it be submissions or whatever the case may be. Or a big time move to really turn things around. And Adrian Cole is in trouble here. Richmond also in trouble. Richmond has a little more leverage at this point to get out of that, swatted away. Gets caught right in that swinging neck breaker, beautifully done. Richmond going right after Adrian Cole. Adrian Cole slips onto the outside there. Flies off the ropes here. Oh! That's what I'm talking about right there. You do not want to get caught in that. Okay, oh my gosh, if you can go back and replay that, how close was that kick? How close was that kick to her fucking legs there? She easily could have had her crumble. Hanging on, trying to hang on as much as she could, but that strength that Alexis brings into this ring is no joke. And almost tossed her right over the fucking top rope here. Oh my gosh. The best thing you hope for these girls is they don't fucking kill each other in or outside the ring. And outside is just as bad as on the inside. A lot of more toys to play with and a lot more walls to fall into. And Adrian Cole, do what she has to do. Oof! Adrian Cole flying to the top as quickly as she possibly can. The referee at five here. Doh! fucking found a way to get herself out of that. Resets the count, does Adrian Cole, and now Alexis now wants to do things her own way here. Now just throwing those punches right into the face. Richmond has Alexis, sorry, has Adrian where she wants her. Again, toss her into those. Oh my gosh, just again. Oh, may want to get a count of victory here. If Adrian Cole can't get in the ring, she'll win this thing automatically. The little Alexis. But Alexis right on the back on the outside here for that count. Not many people want to win that way, but she wants to win fair and square. Regardless of what you think of Alexis, she's a very can be very respectful when she wants to be. And right now, she wants to win this thing very square. She wants to hit that kick. She wants to hit that fucking DDT. Something to really get things going for herself. Oh! Holy shit, these girls are bringing it. Reversal again. Trying to get back in the ring. Agent Cole rolls back in the ring at a 7. Again, another modified Hurricanrana there. Sorry, modified head scissors. Takedown. This. You know these girls are always going for something. Hey, look at this. Look at the work that was just shown there by Adrian Cole. Adrian Cole has her where she wants her. Set up for something here. Crossface may do it. This crossface may do it here. Going after her here, holding on as much as she possibly can. This is a bad spot right now. Alexis fighting for those fucking ropes. Fighting for those ropes there. See her trying to reach for those ropes. Trying to see her reach for those ropes there. Holding on as much as she possibly can. This match could easily be over. This match could easily be over. She are reaching for those fucking ropes there. I don't even think she knows where she wants to go right now, but Adrian Cole has no choice but to let go. Probably one of the longest submissions we've seen in a while. Oh, she tried to punch her and she got caught. She got caught there. Oh, we're full speed, caught her out of midair, caught her on the top rope with that kick. And this just could be it right here. What the hell is she going for? Superplex from the top, she tossed her. Adrian Cole not here to play games. Adrian Cole here to finish. Finished off Alexis Richmond. She just might. Going for something big. Body splash right across the chest. Adrian Cole waiting. I don't know what exactly her plans are, but I'll tell you what, it's not going to be good. Reversal there, and Alexis still fighting in this one, taking no shorts from this girl at all. This girl takes no shorts, and she's ready to fucking win this thing, and now putting her on the top rope for something big. That one reversal just may have tossed Adrian Cole silly for a moment here. Look at this! No! Richmond has her where she wants to have her. That's on that rope, setting up for something big. This could be it right here. And bulldog on that springboard. Holy shit. This match back and forth there. Two. No. And she throws the hand up to make that save one more time. Drop kick right to the face. Oh my gosh, she's kicking her. Those aren't small kicks here, ladies and gentlemen. Those are fucking painful kicks, and she just blasted her with that. Oof. No. Adrian Cole now has where she wants to toss it over the top. This is where she wants to be. She's going for something big. I don't know what she's going for, but I'm telling you what, it's not going to be good. It's not going to be good. Flying off that rope with all full speed here. Oof. I'm telling you, these girls are not nice at all. I don't know what Adrian Cole's next plan is, but she's not. She's running on fumes here too. This is as much as Alexis Richmond is. Richmond fighting out of that. Oh, swatted it away, and again caught in that crossface. Adrian Cole knows that's not gonna work. Adrian Cole knows that's not gonna work. She knows that Alexis Richmond has too much in her. Go. Oh! Richmond again, poising up for that kick. And if Adrian Cole doesn't get out of the way of this, it's gonna be a bad night here for Adrian Cole. Oh, she blasted her right in the head with that kick. And pulling away from the ropes, very smart, very fucking smart is Alexis Richmond to pull away from those ropes to make it. Lanny saves any possible. No. Adrian Cole's here to win. Adrian Cole is here to win here, ladies and gentlemen. Cole is here to win. Oh, he got her with it. That fucking jumping cutter just may do it. That jumping cutter just may have done it. 1, 2, 3, and this one is over. That kick, I thought that would be it. I thought that easily could have been it, but fucking Adrian just had that little bit of extra, just a little bit extra in her here tonight. But take no shorts at either of these two. They went in from start to finish, and it just kept on going, and it never stopped until one of these two fucking pinned the other one out or submitted the other one out. This was just crazy from start to finish. I enjoyed every last bit of this. Great fucking match from two great athletes. These girls brought it. Kick right to the face right there. And right there, easily could have been it. She pulls her right to the middle of the ring to make sure that she has no chance of a rope break or anything of that sort. And still, somehow, some way, kicks out at two. Kicks her right to the midsection. You think that she'll go for another kick to the midsection, but catches it with a fucking cutter just to get even more closer, quicker to the ground, and got her with that fucking jumping cutter. That's how you do it. Anyways, that's just our second match of the night. This thing has gone on for a damn long time, but we're not done just yet. We still got more matches to come, because up next, JP York makes her a return to Divas. We haven't seen her in like a couple months almost at this point, and she takes on Jessica Page, who's always ready to go. Let's see which one of these two can win this thing up next here on Divas. Let's start our third match tonight here, ladies and gentlemen. These two chickens are on. Jessica Page and JP York know each other so damn well. The size advantage definitely goes towards Jessica Page. Experience goes towards JP York just by a little bit. But I'll tell you what, Jessica Page is no slouch in that ring by any means necessary. Because like the new attire I have for JP York, as the match goes on, you'll start to see it a little more. But right now, these two are fucking locking horns. And now JP York showing off her strength here by a little bit. Breaking up that hole once again. Oh! Go! Right back into the clinch, these two are. Jessica Page with an advantage here. JP York fights out of it, snapmare right into a fucking headlock. And then wrenching at the neck again, and throwing that knee into the back. Gotta believe that JP York did not like that fucking that cheap shot to the face, and once again, Jessica Page with the advantage. But gets right out of it again, this is JP York. JP York now with the advantage of her own. Has that wrist locked up. Throws her down beautifully. So wrestling is finding that opportunity to find that spot. And right now, JP York finding that spot. JP York so damn quick in this ring. Oh! Almost tossed Jessica Page out of the ring at this point. Very calm before the storm kind of match here. Oh! JP York can give a fuck. Sorry, Jessica Page can give a fuck less about anyone else. But so can JP York. JP York has her not caring moments. She's a girl that cares, but she will beat the fuck out of you too. And she will not give a fuck about beating the fuck out of you. Oh! Back kick there. Another one. Oh! Ducked under that. No! Oh. When you're as tall as Jessica Page, that supermodel-esque body, when you get slapped from someone as short as JP York, I'm telling you, you're gonna feel it. You're gonna feel all of it because she's gonna hit you right in the face. Jessica Page somehow, someway. Sets up for something. Neck breaker! Jessica Page set up for a fucking belly-to-back suplex. Got caught up, and JP York takes advantage with that fucking diving fucking corkscrew senton to... No! Jessica Page kicks out of two. No dummy by any means. JP York knowing she wants to keep that stamina away from Jessica Page. Very smart, very smart, very fucking smart, I'm telling you. hook on the leg again, just throwing her body, as small as she may be, across Jessica Bay. She knows that it's going to cost her more and more stamina to keep down on that. And going for the pin again and again, the referee has no choice but to make the pin. Oh, missed the kick by a fucking hair, by the edge of her hair, I'm telling you. Reversal by Jessica Paige. Pace out coming. Big time, big boot. Just run right across the face. And JPO is so damn short compared to Jessica Paige that boot is not as hard to throw up as another wrestler, maybe around the same size as Jessica Paige. Jessica Paige, no small girl by any means. Almost hitting us, I believe, at a fucking 5'10". She is no small girl in this ring. Bigger than some guys, actually, we have here on Pure Intense Wrestling and Crash Japan. Swats that arm away. Oh, forearm shot to the face. And she's going for that super, super kick. Schoolgirl super kick, just maybe doing it right there. Referee, 1, 2. No, and Jessica Paige almost got that 3. Oh, you could see the frustration showing on her face there. JP York knows that's not gonna be easy night either. Oh my gosh, look at this. Oh, nicely done there. Oh my gosh, what is she doing? What's she doing? Oh, threw that knee right across the arm there. She was coming down and now throwing the knee across the chest of Jessica Paige here. If you're a girl, it hurts just as much as if you're a guy. Setting up for something here. Standing sure knew she got all of it. This could be it right here. 1, 2, only 2. Frustration now being shown on JP York's face. JP York knows that she just may have this one in the back, but she needs to stay focused. She needs to stay focused here. Look at this. No, shining wizard across the head. And JP York just may have this one. Jessica Paige may be out here too. No, and Jessica Paige showing off her resiliency in this one. Do not let the fucking cute looks of Jessica Paige fool you. She's not just a supermodel. She is a wrestler. And right now she is wrestling and staying in this one, showing off her resiliency in this match. Oh, and disrespectful slap there by JP York. JP York taunting away. Pulling to the middle of the ring. Set up for a Frankensteiner, I believe. Yes, it is. Got all of it, too. Hooks those long, beautiful legs of Jessica Pages. Oh, but only a 2. Clothesline taking her over. This is what I'm talking about. JP York in control. Same way that Jessica Paige would taunt her, now she's taunting Jessica Paige, and you know Paige does not like that by any means. Uh-oh. Slowing the pace down just by taking her by her head. Nope. Look at this. Oh! She saw her throw the kick out, and when you throw the kick like that, too. No! When you throw the kick like that, you don't really have a lot of time to recover, especially when you throw it at that force that JP was throwing it at. And Jessica Paige took advantage of that with that fucking DDT. Oh, standing Shorinui again. Standing Shorinui again. She got it again. Setting up for that octopus stretch. Oh my gosh, she has her fucking body contorted the way she wants it. Right, just the way she wants it. This one could easily be over here. This one could easily be over. Has no choice. You see her tapping out. You see her tapping out, tapping her spine, saying, "This is, I'm done. I'm done." And just JP York just fucking taunting away. And Jessica Paige. A dangerous individual this girl is, I'm telling you, and it's never been mistaken by any means. This is probably one of the most dangerous women we have here. One of the most dangerous women we have on Divas, and that says a lot. JP York still hasn't cashed in that money in the bank yet either. So yeah, like I said, it's all about timing and when that time comes. When is it gonna happen? When is she gonna cash in that money in the bank? Oh, and then we saw that French kiss easily, and she's taken out a many with that, but it wasn't enough just yet. And JP York has been a victim of that move, and also if he's getting pinned up to that move, but it wasn't until the octopus stretch, that Black Widow, that this one was over. You see JP York right there just taunting away at a down Jessica Paige there. Anyways, let me stop getting mixed up with the fucking JP and Jessica Paige, all that. It's fucking driving me insane. Anyway, guys, up next, Yuta Hime takes on Naomi. Naomi returning to Diva's action here tonight. The question is she, I know she's not 100%. It's not even a question. The question is, can she win this thing? Can she get a win for herself? It's been long overdue for Naomi to get a championship shot here, a championship victory, a rematch, to be more exact. The question is, can she do it? We'll find out soon enough. Up next, as she takes on Yuta Hime, who is no damn joke in that ring. We'll find out which one of these two can win this thing up next on Divas for the Divas Television Championship. This is for the Divas Television Championship as Yuta Hime takes on Naomi. And Yuta Hime already knows that Naomi's not 100%. She's gonna aim for that head, the same head that she went after before. And now aiming for already with those fucking strikes and already knocking her down. And you see Naomi just in trouble here. Just in so much fucking trouble already. Set up for something, but no. Naomi saw it coming a mile away. Oh, reverse atomic drop. Naomi may not be 100%, but she's going to bring it as much as she can here in this one. I'm telling you. Oh! Oh, my goodness! But Naomi, bring it! Bring it right now! Holy shit! Oh! Maybe I brought it enough, though. Oh, clips are right out of the sky. So Naomi trying to make the dive there, but caught as much as the... Oh! And Yuta Hime just may have landed on those steps there. Fucking A. Oh, oh! Just throwing those... Again, just knocking her down. I mean, she went down like a fucking speeding bullet here. We've seen this before from Yuta Hime. She just will fucking wreck you no matter where you are. Dropkick to the back. Going outside the ring. Just to go back outside once again. We're rolling inside to go back outside. My gosh, no. Oh! Naomi's in trouble here, and Yuta Hime can give a fuck less. She does not like Naomi, not liking the fact that she's fighting back here. Oh my gosh, fucking A. Referee out of five, and Yuta Hime's just playing with Naomi here. Referee out of seven there. Naomi's caught up. Oh my gosh, that head has been taking so much damage. Taking so much damage, and Yuta Hime could get, like I said, could give a fuck less at this point. Now Yuta Hime, it's not the Yuta Hime with shows honor and all that good fucking nonsense. She wants to do damage and kick to the spine. Gosh, she's fucking crazy. And now nowhere to go. Fucking A. This is bad spot right here. This is a damn bad spot here. Naomi has no choice but to tap on the outside, but nowhere to go. And again, Yuta Hime resetting the count. Resetting the fucking count here. But Naomi fighting back here. Hurricanrana taking down Yuta Hime. Referee trying to count as fast as possible where it's... The timing is quick enough here to possibly save Naomi here. Get her back in the ring. But no. Oh! And again, just resetting the count is Yuta Hime. This is bad spot right now. This is a real bad spot. Naomi needs to get up and get out of the way. Yuta Hime wants to do damage. And I mean, Naomi is, like I said, is in trouble here. Oh, no. But Naomi fighting out of it, kick to the midsection. Oh, yeah, you're not gonna strike as quick as Yuta Hime, I'm telling you, you're not gonna strike as quick as her here. Oh, no. Oh, and she lands on that TV monitor. Naomi's in trouble here. A lot more trouble than I expected her to be. I didn't want her to come back like this, especially for this reason. She's not ready. But Naomi's still fighting somehow, some way. German suplex. Hirohime wasting less and less stamina every time she goes into this thing here, and every time she comes back out. Naomi fighting back, even though she's not 100%. I don't know how she's doing it. Oh! Fucking A. Oh my gosh. Runs right into it, a neck breaker now. I love Naomi, but I do not want to see her fucking get hurt any more than this. I have love for Yorihime as well, but man, I mean, Yorihime is not being nice right now to her by any means. Oh, that kick to the face now. I know wrestling is not always going to be nice and, you know, funny all the damn time, but right now Naomi is hurt. Naomi is more than hurt right now. She is fucking, look at her. She's fucking glazy-eyed and everything. Referee out of three here. And every time he fucking says that count, I'm just getting a little more and more scared. Referee out of five. Again, no. Oh! You talk about someone that's gonna really try and break the body down. Yorihime is that girl. Oh! Fighting back though, jawbreaker. Tosses her back in the ring. Naomi knows that she doesn't want to be in trouble here. Oh! Knows that she doesn't want to be in that position at this point, and Naomi looks like she's ready to finish. Looks like she's ready to finish. Let's see what she can do. Catches the leg. And now catching kicks to the legs is Naomi. And oh, fuck. We talk about breaking down the fucking human spirit here, and that's what Yorihime is doing, tossing him back over the rope again. Breaking down the human body as well as Yorihime. Oof, fucking A. Stomping on that fucking arm there. Oof. Elbow to the back of the head. Swatted away. Yorihime now really wants to do damage on that table. I don't know what she's gonna do, but I'll tell you what, it's not gonna be good. But Naomi's still fighting back somehow, some way. Yorihime wants to end shit. Naomi's trying to stay alive in this one. Oh, fighting back. Fighting back though. You can't take her heart away by any means. She still has a lot of heart. And that's nothing you can't take from Naomi, but Naomi's in a lot of trouble. In a lot of damn trouble here. Oh, she got her! And easily this match could be over! This match could be over! 1, 2, 3! 1, 2! No! Holy shit, no! Hime's back up! Hime's back up! This could be it though! This could be it though! Head scissor DDT! 1! No! 1! Yorihime at a 1 here! At a 1 here! At a 1 here! You talk about someone that's gonna keep on fighting! It's gonna be Naomi, but Yorihime has barely even been hurt at this point. Oh! Jawbreaker, nice reversal right under the jaw of Yorihime. Hime fighting back, at least trying to now. You're starting to see that there's some fight being shown by Naomi as well. Forearm shot to the spine. Look at this, springboard DDT out of nowhere. Fucking quick, brilliant, smart move there. And also smart to keep away from those ropes, but again, Yorihime kicks up before the referee's hand even touches the mat. Like I said, no damage has been done to Yorihime. Yorihime is not going to fucking try and stay down for a 3. She's going to try and end this. Reversal there. Snapmare beautifully done. Oh! Every time she hits her in the head, it's just slowing her down again and again and again. And speaking of being slowed down, that could be it. No! Signature move there by Yorihime. Fucking, hey, what is this match turning into here? No! Naomi's not 100%. And when she came in here, she was not 100%. She has to be less than fucking... She has to be going into negatives right now. Fuck. What does it take? What does it take to break someone down? Because Naomi's still fighting here. Yorihime knows this. And Naomi's still fighting. Kick to the midsection. Naomi does not want to repeat what happened last time, and she is fighting back as much as she can. Every time Yorihime tries to put to that table, Naomi says, no, that's not happening. Not to me. Not today. Oh, fuck. And again, that neck break is doing work. The hell is this? No! Naomi still fighting back somehow, some way. Oh my gosh. Oh! Oh, Naomi with a clothesline, taking her off for a game. That could be right there. Naomi, Yorihime could be in trouble here. And I may have spoken too soon. German suplex. You saw her body have nowhere to escape. Usually you do that in the middle of the ring where your body has somewhere to escape. Yorihime is trying to end the career of Naomi here. Drop to the side of the head. Doing extra damage here. Everyone expects this match to go on this long, and the referee, he's allowing us to go just because Naomi's fighting back. But what does it take? What does it take? Oh, punch the face. This running power slam, beautifully done. Naomi's still in this one somehow, some way. Uh-oh. Naomi's going for something big here. Probably that crossbody may be what she wants to do. Swat it away. Oh! Oh! Fucking hey. This thing is not gonna end until Yorihime wants it to end. And as much as Naomi wants to fight back, I don't know. I don't fucking know if she can last anymore. No! He's tying away at Naomi here. Oh, man. She gets up to go right back down, and Hime knows that she has this match. Hime knows she has this match in the bag here. It was never a fucking doubt on her mind. And now Naomi just being dragged across the fucking ring here. We've seen Hime get to this point before, back with Elaine, back in 2K14. We've seen her go to in this mode before. We've seen her in this mode before where she just, anything that gets in her way is getting destroyed, and Hime is the kind of girl to do that. But Naomi's still fighting back. She's trying to stay away from those fucking, that corner, that outside, that fucking post. That post that took her out before. Doof. Doof. We're now trying to do any damage to that arm too. Oh, come on. Come on, Hime. Come on, Hime. No. Oh. Crowd, you can hear him booing them all away. Everyone's standing. They know that this is not where she wants her to be. They know they don't want Naomi here at this point. They know that she came back a little too early. They know that she wasn't 100%. They knew this. Naomi knew this when she was coming into this, and I think she came back simply because of the pride that she has to stomping on the chest of Naomi now. Oof! Reversal! Oh! Every time Naomi, that fucking Hime wants to get something done. Coming to the top, but no, Naomi saw coming a mile away, and now Naomi just may finish this thing here with that fucking head scissors from the top. Oh my gosh, no way! Fucking hey, going for the pin. That could, you never know, that could be it. One, and no. Oh. Return to the scene of the damn crime. Yorihime is trying to do more damage on the outside, on the inside, wherever she wants to go. Wherever she wants to go is where this match is going to go. Reversal again by Naomi. Calf kick taken down. Naomi here. Naomi flying to the top. It's not usual. It's not the usual Naomi to fly up and do something as crazy as this, but you never know. You never know. Oh! Fighting back. Fighting back somehow, some way. Swatted away. Reversal by Naomi. Oh. Oh, she got that leg. She got that leg, and she... Oh! Fucking A. She caught that leg, and that's what she's trying to do this whole time, is catch that leg. Naomi fucking didn't realize that she was right behind her as quick as she was, and that Hime would get up as quick as she did. And now, Hime has her exactly where she wants her. Oh, propped right on that fucking... Oh, no. Trying to return to the scene of the crime here. We just saw this before. We saw this before, and this could be the end. This could be the end of Naomi here. Oh, gosh. Referee at a 4-5 right now. Referee at a 6. Naomi still moving somehow, some way, and that does not make Yorihime happy by any means. Oh! Naomi can somehow, some way get herself out of this thing and win. It'd be a damn miracle. Kick to the side of the head. This night has gone on for so damn long, and we're still not even done yet. We're still not even done yet. Kick to the face again. Taunting Naomi to get up, and Naomi still getting up. Still somehow, some way getting up, and now being choked out. Now being choked out. A rear naked choke just may do it. The rear naked choke just may do it. If Naomi can get out of this, it'd be a damn miracle. I'm telling you, it'd be a damn miracle. This one is over. Naomi has no choice but to tap. I'm surprised she just didn't pass after all that. Fucking A. The crowd booing away at Yorihime here. Holy shit, who was gonna stop her? If she could do that to someone who's kind of 100% and came to this thing even 100%, how the fuck? What? Who? Who's gonna stop her? Who the fuck's gonna stop Yorihime? You saw points where Naomi was fighting back constantly, trying to not go to that table, and she saved herself from not going to that table. But then that fucking big boot on the outside there, crashing her head right into that fucking steel post. There's no give on those steel posts. There's no, those things do not bend. They do not break. There's the only thing keeping this ring from practically falling in on itself there. But that rear naked choke was all she did to get that thing done. Yorihime may have really just did a lot of damage to Naomi here, and there was nothing nice about that at all. Yorihime is on another level right now, and I'm telling you, if someone's gonna stop her, they're gonna have to be fucking bigger and badder than her, and she's pretty bad right now. She is pretty goddamn bad right now. Anyway, guys, up next, Angel Lopez takes on Ashley. I know this night has gone on for a while. Let's try and wrap this thing up here. Anyway, guys, that's up next on Divas. Fucking A. Welcome back to Crash Pants. Sorry, welcome back to Divas. And fucking hey, we just had a horrible thing just happened to Naomi. Naomi making her return here to Divas, and we were expecting it was to be a nice return. The Divas Television Championship was on the line, and she was ready to go. She was ready. She was looking raring and gearing to go, but as that head injury started to flare up after those few punches to the head early on in the match, you started to see where that match was going to end up. No matter how much no matter how much Naomi fought back, Yadahime was always ready to kick out at a one. She knew what she came in to do. She knew that if she were ever to take on Naomi again and she was holding that championship, that she was going to do as much damage as she could to really just keep Naomi away from the championship ever have it again. And that says a lot, and it shows where Yadahime's head is at right now. That she's ready to destroy anyone that gets in the way. Big time forearm shot there, trying to go for a forearm shot there, but it was Ashley. Ashley a little bit taller by a bit than Angel Lopez. Definitely a big difference there. A lot more thicker though is Angel Lopez, but Angel Lopez using that thickness and this little bit of size she just may have over there. Those fucking thick ass legs she has going on there. She uses those legs to toss around her opponents, much like a Rebecca Tracy would. Actually very educated in the world of submissions. Watched the guys like Ric Flair when she grew up and adopted. It has the figure four leg lock apply. She calls it the figure eight. Oh, you saw Angel Lopez get out of that somehow, some way, but only for a moment did that last. Off the ropes. Oh, going off those legs. Is gonna make it quick as she possibly can in this one is Ashley. Oh, and again going for those legs. Just as I speak of the figure eight, she wants to go for it. Going for something big though. Not done just yet as Angel Lopez. Lopez fighting back, but only for a moment did that last. Punch right to the fucking head. Look at this athletic ability here on Ashley. Amazing fucking athletic ability and speed as well. Angel Lopez. In trouble here, wants to turn this thing around. Oh, what the hell? Why was I punching that way? It doesn't matter. Now that backbreaker. Fuck. Actually feeling it. Oh, went for that spear, but Angel Lopez just so damn brilliant. Experience definitely goes to Angel Lopez, and Lopez now setting up for something big. She just may have it. That cradle, that just may be it right there. Two. No, she kicks out a two. How close was that? Ashley, no dummy by any means, gets herself out of that thing quickly. Gets herself out of that ring. Gets herself back in, using those long legs, take a little bit longer to get in the ring. Oh! Ready to fucking go. Oh, now going off those legs. Now there we go. That's the kind of smart I'm talking about there. How fucking brilliant she is to go off those legs, and now doing a damn good job of staying on those legs, as thick as they may be. They are human anatomy parts. And they can be easily broken down, just like anything else. What the fuck is Angel Lopez doing? Angela's trying to think of that table too. Everyone's trying to go for that table here tonight. Spear. Feeling it with that spear. Easily could be right there. Sets up that figure eight. Fucking leg lock beautifully done there. Beautifully fucking done there by Ashley. Locking in that submission, wasting no time here. Angela Lopez in trouble, and she has no choice but to tap. Ashley with a big time victory here. Fucking A, that was quick. You can see the difference between the last match and this match. That was quick. As good as fucking Angel Lopez is, Ashley wants It's a burning desire inside of her to win this whole thing here tonight. She has a burning desire to not only win these matches, but to continue on and become Divas Television Champion or Divas Champion, regardless of such. She wants a belt under her waist, and I believe that she can do it. I believe that she can do it here. If she can do it at some point here tonight. Sorry, what am I talking about? At some point here in the future. Actually, it's definitely something you gotta watch out for here for sure. Anyway, guys, up next, Xena Fiber takes on Rachel Raiden. We see the same thing happen to Rachel Raiden from that Xena Fiber did to Star Dulce last week. Or somehow, some way, Rachel Raiden find a way to get a victory here over Xena Firebird. We'll find out up next in our semi-main event of Divas. This is our sixth match tonight, our semi-main event, and we've seen some crazy eventful things happen here tonight. Strength definitely going towards Xena Firebird. Rachel Raiden a lot more quicker and has a little more experience than Xena Firebird does here for sure by maybe a good 5-6 years, maybe even 7. Xena Firebird, no joke though, jumping over, showing off that strength. Back body drop easily. When you're Xena Firebird and you move the way she does, you just get things done. And that clothesline, holy shit! I mean, she just damn near took her head off with that rolling forearm. She's getting that speed. I don't know what she's doing. Oh! Let you guys know on the update on the injury of I believe Naomi is doing. By the end of this one, hopefully we'll have a update on that when we hear from something from the back. But right now it seems like it might not be here for a while. I'm telling you. Rachel Raiden now having something set up here for sure. Nice, dough. Sits on that arm there. A very smart, very undelicate move there from someone like Rachel Raiden. But everything again, Rachel Raiden's no delicate girl by any means. She's very cute, but don't let that cuteness fool you. Don't let that zombie hot fool you. The girl is fucking ruthless as they come. Another big back body drop once again. Picking her right back up for just more damage. Speaking of more damage, look at this. Choke bomb. Hooks the leg right after. Wasting no time. 1, 2. No. Kicks it at 2. Clobbering her back down. I don't know if that's going to work for too long here. We've seen this Firebird. Firebird just so damn strong. But they're doing it, keeping her down somehow, some way. Keeping her down. Throwing that knee and wrenching that back even more as much as she possibly can. Trying to keep the momentum and the pace back into Rachel Raiden's favor here. That girl's not dumb by any means. This is the kind of girl that has gotten hardcore before. Has started a faction of her own. Has made things and done things here on Divas that many want to do. Many wish they could do. Oh! Rachel running along with... Oof. Nice head scissors there. Talk more about it in a moment. Rachel Raiden along with Lisa Phenom from a 2K14 fame. Oof. Ooh. And Jade as well. Can't forget about Jade. Fucking doing work. They did fucking work way back when. They were fucking killing it. Look at this. Nice reversal there by Rachel Raiden. That was cool. She got out of that. Not many people know how to get out of a military press there and kind of wiggle themselves out of it. They try to wiggle, but Xena Firebird is so damn strong. But they probably didn't get the full leverage on that. Rachel Raiden felt that and took advantage. Sets up that. Oh, Death Valley Driver. She got all of it. Talk about someone that's not playing or any games here. It is Xena Firebird. Right back into a headlock position here. Rachel Raiden bringing her towards the ropes. I don't know what her plans are. Tosses her over with ease. Oh. No. Oh my gosh. Fucking A. Fucking forearm shot right to the arm there. Spinning forearm to the arm there. Rachel Reign trying to block with her arm. Just got tossed right back down. Right up is these two now. These two are standing right back up into a position. Oh! It's a bad position here for Rachel Reign. Xena Fireball wants to finish things, but Rachel Reign doesn't want to allow it to happen. I forget a five. Rachel Reign rolling him up back on the outside here. Oh! Now it's Rachel Reign's turn to go for something big. Uh-oh. It's a bad spot right now. I'm telling you, it's a bad spot. Look at this. Go! Rachel Reign bringing that hardcore, the style that she used to have, and bringing it back. It's like she's never lost it. Oh! You guys wanted a table break tonight somehow, some way, and we got one. Referee got a six here. And Rachel Reign could walk away with a victory here. But Xena Fireball is still getting up. Referee had a 7. Rachel Reign stunning away here, not focusing on her opponent. And she thought she had this one won, but no! And Rachel Reign is standing up here. Forearm shot taking her down. Another one. And Rachel Reign maybe was just playing with Xena Firebird here. Firebird has her where she wants. I mean, sorry. Xena's in trouble here. That's what I'm trying to say. Sit out fucking sidewalk slam there. Sidewalk slam just may have done it here. Referee. Kicks out one. Does Xena. Rachel Reign now has to think what the hell she has to do. But she's been in the ring with her before. She knows what she has to do. She needs to keep on pushing here. Xena Firebird also knows what she has to do to win this thing and just may have Reign in trouble here. Reign fighting out of it, kicks her away. Oh! Look at this. Look at the strength. Look at the strength being shown there. Oh my gosh, this girl is just so damn strong. Ready to go with Xena. Ready to go with Xena, and she's ready for Reign to get up. Or not. Or fucking not. That could be it right there. Set up that fisherman. Oh, suplex. Trying her to get up, but she knows Reign's not going to stay down for that easily. And she's going for a clothesline instead here. Two. No. Reign throws that shoulder up at the last moment. You see the frustration being shown there on Xena here. Oh my gosh, no. This is it. This has to be it right here. Oh my gosh. Oh, she got all of it. Sits right across the fucking chest. One, two, three, and this one is over. No dummy by any means is Xena Firebird. She knew that it wasn't over just yet at that point. She hits the clothesline to really knock her silly for a moment. And right after it hits that glam slam, and that was it. Maybe not been the same way that she got El Star Dulce, but damn near dominant. Damn near dominant in this one, as much as Rachel Reign was trying to show a fight here. Not a lot of fighting when Xena Firebird's in the fucking fray. But right here, as we saw this match turn around, if even for a moment, hey, look at this, just, oh, gosh, everything off that table is flying. Somehow, some way, Xena Firebird gets herself back in that ring, hits that fisherman buster, but we knew it wasn't it. She knew that wasn't it. She was taunting her to get up, but she knew that this wasn't it just yet. Kicked down over a big-ass clothesline, throwing her right back on the back of her head. It wasn't out. She wasn't out just yet, though. Right here, we saw the glam slam smashing her face right into the mat, sitting right across the chest, throwing all of her weight across the chest. And you see a very smart Xena Firebird throw her other hand, her free hand, over one of the shoulders of Rachel Reign there to keep the pressure on her, to keep her shoulders down. That is smart. And Xena Firebird is all about being smart in that ring, strong and beautiful. But anyways, enough about her. She will be doing things big as she returns here to Divas, and she's doing big things. But up next, though, up next, we have our main event as Elaine takes on Demon Yoshida, the winner of this match. Well, actually, I'll explain more because we're running out of time here. I'll explain more when the next match starts up. Well, in our main event, it's Elaine takes on Demon Yoshida. Let's get it on. Up next on Divas. This is our main event of night, ladies and gentlemen, and these two girls are becoming... I mean, Elaine's always been my favorite here on Divas, but Demio, she's easily becoming another favorite of mine as well. I mean, I love all these girls, but goddamn, these two have been bringing it. They've also defeated the current Divas champion, being... Look at this! Nice reversal there by Yoshida. Also being Yamashita. So, you gotta be thinking which one of these two really want it enough. And with that, it was settled that these two couldn't figure out who wanted to take her on first. So whichever one of these two girls defeats each other in a fucking 2 out of 3 style match, not here tonight and not all in one match, but in these next 3 weeks, including this match here. So in the next 2 weeks after this, we'll be seeing these two girls take each other on in singles matches. And whoever wins the 2 out of those three times takes on Yamashita first. It's arm drag there, and the experience definitely goes towards Yoshida. Don't let the cute look of Elaine fool you. Elaine's no joke in that ring. Multiple time Divas champion. Wants to get herself back in this thing here. Oh my gosh, that clothesline just took out. I don't know if you heard their fucking arm smash off the forehead of Yoshida here. Elaine taking advantage of the opportunity. Oh, missed the boot. Oh! Back suplex right there. Yoshida has her where she wants her. Speaking of Yamashita, we'll be in action next week. But it's all about Yoshida and Elaine right now. Like I said before, Elaine, multiple-time Divas champion. Has been in a many feuds with many of the girls you see these days. Mostly the originals, to be more exact, but you know what I mean. Elaine's been there. Oh! With so much force, she tossed it into the ropes, and she even bounced out of it. Elaine's just trying to finish things early in this one. I like to see it. That's what I like to see. Trying to get things done. Big time suplex. She doesn't want to fucking get any chances of it, getting an injury of any sort. You have a week to rest. You have a week to take your time, but a week can really not be long enough, especially when you get injured. Speaking of injuries, talking about Naomi. She will definitely not be competing anytime this fucking year. No! Oh, after what Yuta Hime did to her, I'm expecting to have some kind of repercussion here for Yuta Hime's axe here. And I'm hearing in the back that they may be thinking of just stripping her of the title, but you know Yuta Hime's not gonna fight, and you're not gonna go out with that kind of shit just without fighting for it. This wrestling slam here, and Yoshida just so damn good and so quick and so agile and so on your back. She will stay on your back, and now is trying to keep away. She knows Elaine's not gonna get pinned out this easily. But what she's trying to do right now is try to wear down Elaine here, smashing those elbows up. Elaine's beautiful body being broken down by the much more experienced Demon Yoshida here. And Yoshida now wants to finish this match. But no, Elaine says no. Okay, right to the midsection there. But no, back and forth again. Yoshida. Oh! Sets up DDT. Somehow, some way, Elaine is back in this thing. Just a second ago was Demon Yoshida. Look at this. Oh, kick right to the head. Going for the pin, and she knows she's not going to get an easy win here over Demon Yoshida either. Elaine flying. Oh, a soccer ball kick. Penalty kick. PK. Whatever you want to call it. Maybe it here, but only a 2. Elaine. Demon Yoshida. These girls are bringing it here. Oh. Drop kick. Oh my gosh, Yoshi, now she's going for Yoshida's move here. Elaine's a girl that can take your moves pretty damn easily and make them effective. She's going for that Lion Tamer. That Lion Tamer can easily, as taken on a mini, Demi Yoshida's taken on a mini with that Lion Tamer before. The thing is, she doesn't do it as well as Yoshida does it, and that's going to cost her there. Kick right to the face. Sets up that ravishing neck breaker. And Yoshida just may be out of it here. Two. No, she kicks out of two. No. Lane's not the one to play. Lane's not the one to play around. Lane's the one that kind of wants to finish shit. She wants to finish shit. Oof. What the hell? Out of nowhere, sky high, and she got all of it. Holy shit, that could be it. That could be it right there. One, two, no. Elaine climbing as much as she can to the fucking ropes here. Sets up for something. Side effect, beautifully done. Elaine ready to fly. Not often do you see her Elaine ready to fly, but Yoshida also ready to fly and take her down. Well, whatever the hell she wants to go for. Oh my gosh, look at that. Holy shit. Doesn't hook the legs though. Doesn't hook the legs. Picking her right back up for something even worse. Maybe something even worse. Clothesline taking her down. Another one. Ducks the line. Power slam. Yoshida, no dummy. Taking her away from the ropes. Taking her away from the ropes. And now locking in a Lion Tamer of her own. And this is taken out of many before. Can Elaine be another victim here? Like I said, the experience definitely goes towards Demi Yoshida. But yeah, Elaine has that fighting spirit as well. Trying to fight into this, trying to fight and stay in this thing. You can see her back feeling a lot of pain. You can see the pain in her face. Demi Yoshida not showing any pain. It's hard to see someone's emotions through face paint. It's hard to see someone's emotions through a mask. And right now, Demi Yoshida showing no emotion. Only emotion she's trying to show. Oh my gosh. Fucking A. But she wants to, the only emotion she's showing is that she wants to finish this thing here. Anaconda Vice, she just got all of it. Is it enough now? And that's the signature move of Elaine's there. Fighting back as much as she possibly can. This submission may be locked in as much as she wants it to be. We've seen a lot of submissions here tonight, and only a few have made the finish. Can this be another one right here? Can this be another one to log into the... Nope, I guess not. No! Look at this. Oh my gosh, no. Oh my gosh, no. Vertebreaker. No. Fucking A. I don't know if Elaine, I don't know what Elaine's plans are, but I'm telling you, it's not gonna be good. Oh, missed a super kick. Kick to the midsection there. Yoshida takes advantage. Rolling neck breaker. This match is insane. One, two. No, and she got the three. Holy shit! Back and forth. Elaine got outdone by Demi Yoshida, and Demi Yoshida has been doing a many as of late. This is crazy here. I mean, start to finish, that was insane. And Elaine could have easily made that finish if she hit that super kick. But by a second, Demi Yoshida dodged it. Dodged it by a fucking hair and saved herself. Saved herself in this one. Holy shit. That's insane. That's fucking insane. I missed that pin by just I missed it by a lot. I pressed it way too early. I don't know why I pressed it so early. My mind was like telling me that it was gonna shift up a lot more than it was. And I've kicked out of a lot of shit that I knew I was gonna kick out of. Like, that's not hard to kick out of. I don't know why I fucked that up. Either way, Elaine not winning this first match here that they've been going for, and then that gives Demi Yoshida a big time advantage in this one. I mean, hell, if Demi Yoshida can win again next week, she'll definitely be taking her on. There will be no one else to take on Yamashita. It will be Demi Yoshida versus Yamashita at Flash Magic. What the hell did we just witness here, ladies and gentlemen? This is proof that anything can happen in wrestling. Elaine not easily is pinned out that easily, and Demi Yoshida made it happen with ease. I think she went for that super kick and missed it by just a hair. She missed it by just a hair, and it threw her off. She got twisted into that spinning neck breaker, and it's how quick and how accurate, accurate and how fast was that. You saw how quick that super kick missed and how wet she went right for that swinging neck breaker. There was no hesitation. There was no, oh, let me try this. It was done. Speaking of getting things done, Divas is done here. We went on a little bit more than longer than I usually go, but hey, it is what it has to, it is what it is. Things have meaning. Like I said, the chances of Naomi coming back here to Divas, I don't know. Right now, it seems like it's very slim. Chances are you'll probably see her in not Universe mode anyway. But right now, I don't know what's going on with her. Speaking of not Universe mode, we have not Universe mode episode. If I'm not mistaken, it should be episode 16 up next. So be ready for that, guys. If you're new to this channel and you don't know what the fuck's going on, please, as always, comment, like, subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys at not Universe mode. Until then, whew, getting tired. Peace out and good shit.